Hello students, under unit 4 integral calculus, now we are going to discuss few application problems in integration. Let's get on to the presentation. So let's start with the first problem. The electric charge is distributed over the disk x square plus y square is equal to 1, so that its charged density is rho of x comma y, which is equal to 1 plus x square plus y square of k per meter square. Calculate the total charge of the disk. So how are we going to handle this problem under integration? So now, since we know the Cartesian and polar form, this problem might be very simple to handle it in a polar form. So we know how it is converted, right? So the two-dimensional Cartesian coordinates in polar form is given by x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. And using the Jacobian, we get dx dy is equal to r dr d theta. And also we know that x square plus y square is equal to r square. How did we get this? Because while squaring this x and y, you will be getting r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. So taking r square as the common term, you will be getting cos square theta plus sin square theta, which is going to be 1. So it will result in r square. Now the total area in the polar form is always given by the formula double integral of r dr d theta. So now double integral of dx dy is x equal to double integral of r dr d theta in polar form. So now in this particular problem, we are going to apply the polar form. In polar coordinates, the region occupied by the disk is defined by the set r comma theta. So which means that the radial axis, which starts from 0 to 1. So we consider that as a unit circle disk, and theta varies from 0 to 2 pi, that entire rotation. So now total charge is equal to sigma of x comma y into dx dy, which is going to be the function rho or sigma, which is equal to, so how did I substitute it here? A rho of x comma y is given as 1 plus x square plus y square, right? So 1 is there in place of this x square plus y square. I had substituted r square. Are you getting me? So therefore the function gets changed to 1 plus r square, and dx dy, you know, originally it is done as r dr and d theta. So now what do? I know that the outer integral belongs to d theta. So because theta varies from 0 to 2 pi, and the inner integral 0 to 1 belongs to the variable r, which is varying from 0 to 1. So what I have done, I have just printed the integral. Since it is multiplication, we know the limits perfectly. Integral 0 to 2 pi d theta and integral 0 to 1, 1 plus r square into r dr. Now if this r is outside, it is all in the same characteristic, it's just going to multiply it. So if I'm going to multiply it, I'll be resulting in r plus r cube dr. And what has happened here in the first integral? When I integrate dt theta, I will be getting theta. Theta over the limit 0 to 2 pi. So the upper limit minus the lower limit will result in theta minus 0. In place of theta, if I am going to replace 2 pi, it is going to be 2 pi. Clear? Now if I am going to integrate this r integral, I will be getting 2 pi is outside. If I integrate r, I will be getting r square upon 2. And if I integrate r cube, I will be getting r power 4 by 4 over the limits 0 to 1. So if I am going to substitute the upper limit, I will be getting 1 upon 2 plus 1 by 4. This is plus 1 by 4. And if I am going to substitute the lower limit, it is going to be 0. So if I am going to take the LCM, it is going to be 4, right? So it is going to be 2 plus 1, it is going to be 3 by 4. With 4 getting cancelled by 2. So my final answer is 3 pi by 2 kl. This is the total charge of the disk. So we had converted a Cartesian problem in terms of a polar form using this relation. Next problem, a particle traveling in a straight line passes through a fixed point O on the line with a speed of 0.5 meter per second. The acceleration a meter per second square of the particle at t passing through this O is given by the acceleration is equal to 1.4 minus 0.6 t. Show that the particle comes instantaneously to rest when t is equal to 5. Find the total distance traveled by the particles between 0 and t is equal to 10. So how are we going to handle this? We know the differentiation of velocity gives you acceleration. So since acceleration is given to you, we have to find the velocity. Right? So how do I find the velocity? You know, integration is the reverse process of differentiation. In fact, it is also called as anti-differentiation. So we got to integrate it. So first, how do I start my solution? Given acceleration is equal to 1.4 minus 0.6 t. So if I'm going to integrate this with respect to t, what do I get? 1.4 t minus 0.6 t square upon 2 plus some c. Why this c comes? This has been discussed in the introduction video, where c is called as the arbitrary constant, because as we keep varying c, we might get infinite number of solutions. Now, next target is to find the value of this constant. Then only I can complete this velocity equation. So now you know that given, what is given in the problem? It is given that if the straight line pass, if the particle passes the fixed point at the line speed, it's going to be 0.5 meter per second. So at t is equal to 0, initial velocity v is equal to 0.5 meter per second. So if at t equal to 0, if I'm going to substitute in equation 1, the first term and the second term will become 0. At time v is equal to 0.5, therefore c will be equal to 0.5. Therefore, go back and substitute the value of c in the first equation. So if I'm going to go back and substitute in the equation, I'll be getting v is equal to 1.4 t minus 0.3 t square. These two get cancelled, plus 0.5. Now I have to find what is the velocity at time t. So we have to say that the particle comes instantaneously to rest, which means that my velocity should be 0, right, at time 5. When t is equal to 5, v is equal to 1.4 into 5 minus 0.3 into 25 plus 0.5. So if I'm going to substitute in this particular first equation, I will be replacing all the t as 5, right? So I'm having t square, so I have replaced it by 25. So when I simplify this equation, my answer is 0 meter per second. Therefore, I can conclude that the particle comes instantaneously to rest when t is equal to 5. Clear? We move on to the next section. The total, we have to find the total distance traveled by the particle between t is equal to 0 and t is equal to 10. Now, what am I going to do? First, velocity is already known. V is equal to 1.4 t minus 0.3 t square plus 0.5. Now, to find the distance traveled, I integrate it. So, if I'm going to integrate it over with respect to t, my answer will be t is equal to 0.7 t square by 2, right? So t square by 2, that 2 gets cancelled in 1.4. So your resulting equation is 0.7. And this is going to be 0.t cube by 3. So it's going to be 0.1 plus 0.5 t plus some arbitrary constant k again. So now what do I do? At t is equal to 0, this entire equation is 0. And we know that there is no distance traveled, right? At particular time t, there is no velocity and the particle is at rest, etc. So the distance traveled is 0. Therefore, k is also equal to 0. And if I replace k is equal to 0 here, so s is will be equal to 0.7 t square minus 0.1 t cube plus 0.5 t. Now what do? I have to find at t equal to 5 and t equal to 10. So if it's called at t equal to 5, my answer will be 7.5. And when t is equal to 10, s is equal to minus 25. So distance traveled is just going to be negative direction, nothing else. So now how will I calculate the total distance? But actually I need the distance for the particle from the time t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 10, right? But since I'm having from 5 at 5 and at 10. So 5 to 10, there is a difference. And from 0 to 5, another 7.5. So together 7.5 plus 7.5 plus 25 will give you 40 meter, which concludes that the particle between t is equal to 0 and t equal to 10, it has moved 40 meter away. Thanks for watching. Let's continue in the next session.